I know you guys have been learning about the kidney, so I'm going to do a quick overview and small lesson explaining the kidney and a little bit more in depth about the nephron before we do our dissection. So, is this working? Gotta turn it on, right? So, some just objectives for today. We will be able to describe the structure and the function of the kidney and the nephron, identify the components of a nephron and explain their roles in urine formation, and analyze the relationship between kidney function and overall health. Does this sound familiar? Have you guys talked about this? Great, then you guys should be able to answer these questions. What are the kidneys responsible for?
Filtration.
Excellent, filtration of what?
Yeah.
Waste.
Okay, where do they get the waste?
Your urine.
Your blood.
They get the waste from your blood and they convert it to urine, right? So what kind of waste? What kind of waste do they take?
Nasty waste.
Which is made of what?
Urine.
No, they make urine.
Oh. You got me.
The waste comes from our metabolism. So protein metabolism, it could be extra fluids, extra ions, extra stuff that our body doesn't need and decided to get rid of. Okay, so what other body systems affect the kidney or are affected by the kidneys? This is a thinker. If you need to use notes, you can. Or if you just want to take a guess, go ahead. So what other body systems affect or are affected by the kidneys? Can the kidneys work alone without having any influence by anything else?
No.
Nervous system.
Your nervous system. Exactly. What else?
The cardiac.
Yeah.
Aren't they part?
Cardiovascular system. So your blood, right? Because that's where they get it, right? That's where they get their blood and waste to filter. So, anything else? Any other body systems we can tie? How about the skeletal system?
No.
Can you think, is that tied to the kidney?
I mean, like,
I would think so.
I wouldn't.
Is it sitting on one of these bones right here?
Well, not exactly.
I wouldn't think so.
I really don't know. Here's an interesting way that the skeletal system is tied to the kidneys, okay? So the skeleton, what are the bones made of? What's the skeleton made of? A lot of it. What ions, right? Like you say, oh, you need to drink milk for calcium, right?
Yeah.
Well, calcium is one of the ions that the kidneys are in charge of filtering and determining the amount that gets excreted in the urine. So if you have a problem with your kidneys and you're excreting too much calcium, your body could actually, to get more calcium if it's not in your diet, your body could actually leach it from your bones, right? Calcium and phosphorus. What about your digestive system?
Digestive system.
How does that affect? Can you think of how that would affect your kidneys?
Because it gets all the bad stuff from it.
You know what? As generic of an answer that is, you do have a excellent point.
Wait, you're saying that was a dumb answer?
So your digestive system produces ends up with, well. If your kidneys are not working properly and they can't get rid of all that waste, high levels of urea in your blood can cause issues in all parts of your body, especially the digestive system. So one symptom of kidney issues are nausea, poor appetite, peptic ulcers, and vomiting. And of course, your circulatory system, right? What about the muscular system? Think about ions. Have I talked about the muscles yet?
Mm-hmm.
We talked about ions. Oh, ions.
So, let's say you're exercising and maybe you haven't had enough water and you get a cramp. What is recommended for you to do?
Yeah,
electrolytes.
Electrolytes are bananas, right? With potassium, those electrolytes are important for your muscles to function. If you have a problem with your kidneys. Well, you may have more cramps because your kidneys are letting too many ions go that your muscles need. How do the kidneys keep the body in homeostasis? And what else imbalances? What have I just been talking about? Yeah, ions. They keep the body in homeostasis with water, and ion ratios, keeping them at a good level. It's conducive for your body. All right, what do you think would happen if the kidneys stopped functioning?
You stop functioning.
Eventually, yeah, but can you think of any specifics? Based on what you've learned already? So if the kidneys...
Well, when you go into kidney failure...
Your blood would be full of waste.
That's nice.
Anything else?
You get really sick.
Wouldn't be able to get the waste out.
Your body wouldn't be able to get the waste out.
Go back up to your heart, then you just die.
Exactly. That's exactly what happens. No, it would take a while, but if your kidney shut down, it would affect a lot of air in your life.
Just show them. Don't go in front of them.
Yeah. Oh, it's okay. You go ahead. Just go ahead.
Limbo.
They didn't even see you.
Okay, just to catch you up, we're still doing the kidney dissection, but we're doing a quick lesson first. And I'm a graduate student doing a recorded teaching for one of my classes, so I have a little camera set up right there. Oh, and you need notes.
Here. We're talking about the kidneys.
Alright, since he just came in, we have to start from the beginning.
She's joking.
I'm kidding. Of course I'm kidding. So, just to make things more difficult for you guys, we're going to do just a quick little activity to get you thinking.
Yes.
So, here are a few symptoms. And I put the... basically what it is, and I put the medical name for it. So, let's see. We have four tables. Let's have each table pick a symptom and use what you've already known in your notes and tell me how the kidneys could relate to that system, okay? So first we have muscle cramps. I kind of just said it to you, but you guys should know that, obviously, since I just said it, and you should say it back to me. You have swelling of the hands and feet, which is called peripheral edema. That could be a symptom of kidney malfunctioning. We also have frequent and infrequent urination, which is called polyuria if it's too much urination, or oliguria if it's not enough. We have high and low blood pressure, hyper and hypotension, and we have itchy skin, uremic pruritus. So, let's have each table pick one. So let's start with these ladies in the front. Which one do you want?
High and low blood pressure.
Great. So you guys start thinking of ideas. And there's space to write it down in the back. You can use your book. You can use what we talked about. So just use your prior knowledge, or if you want to use speculation, then just guess it. You're welcome to. Gentlemen, which one would you like?
Gentlemen.
Muscle cramps.
Yes.
Yeah, well, muscle cramps.
Ladies?
The high low blood pressure.
High low blood pressure. You guys.
What? Let's go muscle cramps.
Oh, they've already been chosen.
You can't be chosen.
That's already been chosen.
No respect.
This should be super easy. You guys have already covered this. Itchy skin. Excellent. Excellent. So, take a moment, talk about it amongst yourselves, and think of how problems with kidneys or kidney malfunctioning could cause the symptoms that you guys have chosen. It doesn't have to be right. Just give me some kind of answer. You can use your book, too. Absolutely. So which one did y'all choose?
Kidney failure, right? You got all your waste circulating back up your blood.
Yeah, she like
faked it. What? Hey, you calm down over there, man. gets infected, right?
Yeah.
You get a, somehow correlate with you having
it. Okay.
Yeah, bro, that's a big red flag.
Yeah, hold on to that thought.
I will.
And we'll go up, bro.
Hold on to save that for later.
Yeah, right now.
Explain.
Do y'all need a minute?
Yes.
Why are you late, Justice?
So you see what happens when an alarm doesn't go off. The person doesn't wake up.
Don't say it like I'm stupid or something. I just asked why you were late.
My alarm didn't go off.
Okay, that's all you have to say.
My parents.
Hey, y'all.
Yeah. Yeah, Dr. Crawford's gonna
see this.
Do you like grad school?
Yes. There's a lot of different aspects to it. I think I'm used to biology classes. And I love biology. And I'm taking aquatic ecology this semester.
And we're
going to different creeks and like fishing and like catching all kinds of awesome stuff and like digging holes to see how much water is on the ground. The education classes are very like helpful, but they're just not quite as fun. But
yeah,
it'll all work out. It's all gonna. It's adding up. How y'all doing, ladies? Y'all ready?
I think so.
Okay, we're gonna let y'all go last. So, you guys, what was your symptom again?
Itchy skin.
Itchy skin, okay, how could issues with the kidneys cause itchy skin?
Because they don't filter all the bad stuff, right?
Okay.
Okay, it goes right back up into your bloodstream and we'll get infected.
Okay. Yeah, you basically got it. So if your kidneys aren't working, if your kidneys can't filter out those wastes and toxins, they go back into your bloodstream and wreak havoc everywhere else they go, right? So your rheumatoid arthritis is actually a symptom of malfunctioning kidneys. So very good. It can have effects on your skin.
Well,
what was your symptom again?
The high and low blood pressure.
High and low blood pressure. Okay, give us an explanation.
So for high blood pressure, it says you're not peeing, it's not getting rid of extra fluids that might be in the blood. Low blood pressure, I don't know.
Low blood pressure? Can anyone else think of how low blood pressure?
Not enough force to make filtration.
Yeah, not enough force, or an imbalance with ions and fluids. So good job. You guys, muscle cramps, right?
Muscle cramps.
Okay.
So basically, if your kidneys aren't processing your fluids and electrolytes properly, then your muscles are going to have a harder time getting the right nutrients and fluids, so you're more likely to have muscle cramps.
Very good. Do you remember what part of your kidney specifically, the filtering unit of the kidney, that's responsible for that?
Let's see.
It's the loopy thing, the squiggly thing?
The hilum?
No, it's okay. Just hold on to that thought. We'll get to it.
Okay.
All right. What was y'all's symptom?
High and low blood pressure. If it's too low, then there's not enough force to make it filtrate. And then if it's too high, then you're getting all the proteins and all that, like, too much out.
Yeah. Great answer. Okay, so we can get into the body of the lesson. So if you're not already there, you guys can go ahead and flip to the notes because you're just filling the blank. I'm just going to do a quick overview. You guys are usually do like, with that down or up?
Usually up.
Okay. Find along the posterior, so the back muscular wall of the abdominal cavity, and they're retroperitoneal, right? You guys learned that?
Yes.
So what does that mean?
It's outside of
they're not inside the body cavity, so they don't have that extra protection that, like, let's say, like, your pancreas and your intestines have. But what they do have is fat around them. But the kidney is a waste filtering and disposal system of the body, which you guys should know. And about a third of all blood leaving the heart passes into the kidneys to be filtering before flowing into the rest of the body. About a third, so literally a third of the blood, as soon as it leaves the heart, travels down here and goes into the kidneys. Why would that be important?
So you have clean blood?
Exactly. So you have clean blood to let your kidneys clear it up a little bit before it goes to the rest of your body. And again, the primary function of the kidneys is the excretion of waste products resulting from protein metabolism and muscle contraction, which actually can produce urea, which is a toxic substance initially until your body converts it into urea and then waters it down to make it more dilute. The left kidney is actually located slightly more superior than the right kidney due to the large size of the liver on the right side of the body. So they don't have the protection of the abdominal cavity, but they still have the protection of muscles on your back and your ribs to protect them from damage. Adipose tissue known as perirenal fat surrounds the kidneys and acts as protective padding. So perirenal, what does renal mean? Renal means kidney. What does peri mean?
Outside.
Around. Right? Yeah. Great. Okay, so here's our basic model of the kidney that we're looking at today. And we'll be using this picture for the dissection too. But essentially, renal arteries branch directly from the abdominal aorta and enter the kidneys. So your abdominal aorta is going to be here. It enters the kidneys here, and it branches all the way to the outside, which is the renal cortex. So the renal cortex is the solid-looking outermost part of the kidney. It contains many small arteries and veins that carry blood to and from approximately 1 million nephrons located in the cortex. But the medulla is the middle portion of the kidneys here. It's inward from the cortex, and it includes these cone-shaped renal pyramids. And these are fibrous and striped triangle-shaped zones in the medulla that contains collecting ducts. And collecting ducts do exactly what they sound. They collect urine from the kidney tubules of the nephrons in the cortex, and they have these columns that will drain it into the ureter and put the secreted product back into the veins. The waste product is called urine, which you guys should know. And actually, do y'all know what micturition is? Did y'all learn about that?
Yes.
Isn't that a funny word just to describe pee? Yeah, so they excrete urine, which is going to be emptied from these calyces. The singular is calyx, the plural is calyces. Down into the renal pelvis, which is just this open part down here, and into the ureter, which drains into the bladder. So if you know anyone who's had kidney stones, which can be incredibly painful, this is where they end up. This is where they're formed, and they end up in the ureter. Doesn't that just sound painful?
Yes.
Yeah,
it
does sound fun.
Okay, do y'all have the notes from the slide?
No.
Y'all still writing?
I'm
still writing.
I'm good.
You're good. Almost done.
Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Great. Uh-oh, that's not supposed to be in there. Yeah. It's a nasty, dirty refrigerator, right? So let's say I ask you guys to clean this refrigerator.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, you would all tell me no, right?
Yeah.
But you have to.
How much money you
need? You just get. Yeah, you don't get any money. You just have to clean this refrigerator. What's the first thing you would do?
I would throw all that away.
Well, maybe some of it's still good.
No, it's all surrounded by all that stuff.
Okay, well, we're gonna assume that some of it's still good for this purpose.
Okay.
So you guys wouldn't just start cleaning down here, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you would have to take everything out,
right?
Yeah. That's the best way to do this, right? I mean, you take everything out, you'd sort through it. The bad stuff, you'd throw away. The good stuff, you'd put back in. You'd clean it up. But basically, to clean it, the best way to clean it is going to be first to take everything out of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what your nephrons do with your blood, essentially. So, the glomerular capsule is where filtration happens. So filtration is basically the first step of this. It's where it takes pretty much everything out of your blood except for large cells and proteins that are too big to enter. So it takes fluid waste products and ions, so like a lot of the bulk of your blood, and it takes it and puts it into the nephron itself. The glomerulus is located inside the glomerular capsule. Glomerulus basically is like means ball of yarn. And doesn't it look like that?
Mm-hmm.
So first it takes all the good stuff out of your blood, except for the stuff that's too big to pass through. Take a look at the glomerulus and also just the whole shape of the nephron in general. How do you think the shape of the nephron is conducive to help it accomplish its function? We're dealing with a lot of filtering, right?
Mm-hmm.
So there's stuff going back and forth between the blood and these tubules, right? So what about that shape makes it great for what it's doing?
Thorough.
What'd you say?
It's thorough because
it is very thorough. Exactly. And it's really long. What about its length? There's like a specific phrase I'm looking for. So stuff is diffusing back and forth,
mm-hmm.
right? And it's really long.
Gives you room.
It gives room, which surface area, right?
Mm-hmm.
It has a large surface area. And there's lots of twists and folds, and it's very convoluted, which just gives it even more surface area so it can properly do its job. Okay, everybody got that slide? Next we have reabsorption. Reabsorption happens in the proximal convoluted tubule. So the stuff that gets taken out of the blood is called filtrate. So once it enters this, it's not urine quite yet, it's not finished, it's called filtrate. The proximal convoluted tubule is responsible for reabsorbing 50 to 60% of the glomerular filtrate, including glucose, amino acids, and electrolytes and vitamins, back into the blood. So this is you taking your sweet tea and your shredded cheese, which I know you all eat at 10:30 every night,
yes.
And your deli meat and putting it back into the fridge, because you're going to need those things. So reabsorption is where it takes some of the important things and puts them back. So this can be passive, which uses no energy, or it can be an active process, which is going to use energy. What kind of molecules are going to use no energy? What do you think?
I'm going to go with melanin.
Well, I just said this can be passive.
Yeah.
So there has to be some, right? Water, basically. Osmosis, right? So what about active? So what kind of stuff is going to use energy? If it's going to use energy and it can't get through on its own, then that pretty much means like it's really big, or it has like weird charges. So basically, what do y'all think is going to need energy to get back through that membrane? Remember amino acids, right?
Yes.
Y'all know what I cistern of proteins. Alright, are you ready for the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Great. Reabsorption and the loop of Henle. Did y'all call it the loop of Henle?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, my dad's a veterinarian. I was talking to him about this morning. His professors in college called it the loop of Henle.
Whoa.
The loop of Henle. You see, it's kind of confusing. Everybody has like a different pronunciation for different things, and it kind of drives me crazy because I don't like to be wrong. But there's different ways to say it. So the loop of Henle also does a lot of reabsorbing. So the proximal convoluted tubule is going to reabsorb a lot of like your big proteins, like your ions and your amino acids. The loop of Henle is mainly to reabsorb water and sodium chloride from the filtrate. So the loop of Henle does a lot of water conservation for the organism and produces highly concentrated urine. So I was talking with Dad about this morning, and he brought up something really cool that I wanted to share with you guys. Now, have you ever heard of the kangaroo rat?
No.
Okay, what's this little rat that lives in the desert? He's got these big legs and he kind of hops around like a kangaroo. But he's a desert dwelling creature. And those little mice, like really tiny guys, they have the longest loops of Henle, like that are known. Okay, that makes sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, since the loop of Henle is in charge of water reabsorption, can't you imagine that the longer it's going to be? The better the reabsorption. I mean, the kangaroo rat has longer loops of Henle than like animals much bigger than its size. So they can go a long time without drinking water. They get water from their diet, so like seeds and stuff that they'll eat does have liquid, and they produce metabolic water. But the longer the loop of Henle, the better it's functioning, the more water you're able to conserve. Next we have secretion, which occurs in the proximal and distal tubules. So waste and ions will pass from the capillaries into the renal tubule. This is called secretion. So secretion and reabsorption can get a little bit confusing, but basically the key here that I would probably highlight is reabsorption moves solutes from the tubule to the blood. So it's reabsorption, so they're going back where they came from. So tubule to blood, right? And then secretion moves solutes from the blood to the lumen of the tubule. So the stuff that's secreted is eventually going to make our urine. So blood goes in here. Some of it stays in here, some of it goes back to the blood. It's down to our loop of Henle, where some of it stays in here and some of it goes back to the blood. Then same thing here, and the stuff that needs to stay in the blood that your body's decided to hold on to will go back here and enter this vein. And the stuff that your body's getting rid of, so your waste, is going to go out the collecting duct into the calyces, renal pelvis, ureter, bladder. Then out whenever you decide. Or maybe if you haven't decided. I don't know about y'all's. So, yeah, we're ready for lab now. So, just a couple little things, guys. Please do not eat or drink while we're doing this. We're dealing with some chemicals here, and you don't. It's good practice not to have anything to eat or drink in the lab. So, if you need to drink water or step out in the hallway, you're welcome to do that, but not while we're doing the next section. Proper PPE. Do you guys have gloves? Yeah, you guys will be wearing gloves for this to keep your skin safe. Another one, misuse of lab tools and equipment will result in dismissal from class. Y'all hear that? Everybody hear that? Now repeat it back to me. No, I'm just kidding. So we're dealing with some sharp objects and some things that could hurt you or other people. But you guys are being entrusted with these, supervised, and if you guys are using things that's not their intended purpose, I don't have a problem just sending you out and you won't be able to participate. Sound good? Follow directions. So I'll have directions, and there's directions in your handout. And after we are finished, you guys just need to wash your hands and sanitize the desks. And I don't know how we'll handle cleanup. up if you all do that, or I don't mind doing that. But we'll just get to that when we get to it.
Good.
All right, here's our model. So first, we're going to dissect the kidney, and we're going to identify the parts in bold. So the handout has different parts in it that you guys will need to identify. Also, when you are finished and you can identify them, show me.
Yeah.
Do it. You thought this was going to be fun, right? No, it's not going to be fun. You guys are going to have to work for this. No, I'm just kidding. So when you finish and you can tell the different parts apart, well, call me over and show me the different parts, and also show me the path of blood flow through the kidney and through the nephron. Show me the path of blood flow. Show me where it comes in. Show me where the blood goes out. And show me where the urine comes out.
Let's do it.
Okay? That sound good? And then after that, I want you guys to answer some questions on the last page. And there's also going to be a drawing, because drawings are fun and they really help you learn.
Yay!
So I want you to do a drawing. Yes. Absolutely. So let's go ahead and make room for our dissecting trays. We got gloves being passed around.
Oh, we should.
Yeah, we're gonna make a lateral cut on the kidney when we get it.
What
did you do? Oh my goodness. I might need help with this.
Oh, Troy's pretty strong. Why do you open those at work? What do you do at your job?
There's buckets of icing.
Icing?
Yeah.
Why do we not put that? I see a lot of liquid in there.
Yeah, so be careful.
There is a lot of liquid,
okay.
So yeah.
That is sus.
So, yeah.
Oh, wow, that's good for you, Justin.
Oh, I didn't pull the thing off. Look at that. I want to be a professional
makes
later,
sense.
Right? So there are actually 8 kidneys. So now we only have 4 dissection trays set up and like 4 scalpels and everything. But if you guys want to do like 2, you're welcome to. Also, these are from last year. So
what?
It may be difficult to like see the features. But
4-year-old.
All right. Can I have some money from each group bring your tray up here, please?
Justin, would you like more money? No.
Absolutely not.
See? This is gonna be fun. This is so weird, bro. Oh no. No.
Thanks.
Love it.
I have my paper.
Love it.
We just wanna take a bite.
She's a hungry one.
Great. So I'm gonna try to cover the smell up. Yes, it is. I also have pins. If you would like that.
Back up.
Oh,
leave.
Okay. marinade
all. Yeah, well, we got
to. Y'all want to switch it out?
It's fine.
No, it's fine.
Alright, so can we just go at it?
Yeah, well, I would look at your instructions.
Where's our instructions?
They're in the handout.
Oh, Justin, you get the instructions.
That smell is making my smell.
Yeah, so you're going to cut it laterally, so you're going to cut it the way you see it in that picture.
I bet. So pretty much right on there.
Yep. Which one of those?
Is it the partial?
Okay, look.
I'll read it.
I'm not touching it. Examine the outside of the kidney. Okay? Examine.
Alright, what's
the kidney?
What?
It looks like the kidney. What is the matter?
All enters the kidney.
What questions are we supposed to be answering?
The questions are on the last page.
The ureter, renal artery, and renal vein are all in the same kidney.
Yes, they're all in the same kidney.
There, sir.
And if you would like pins to pin it down after you make your cut, I have those as well.
Yay!
You're
the
cut yourself.
No, what's there?
Just write it out loud.
Use fat off
number two.
What? Identify the ureter, renal artery, and renal vein.
Renal artery, renal vein.
There's the ureter.
Alright, the ureter should be pretty easy to find. The renal artery and vein, sometimes they'll kind of lose their color. Well, they're in storage.
I'm gonna say that's
the renal vein.
I'm gonna say that's the renal vein. That's the renal vein. Okay, what else?
Look at that.
So,
renal artery.
Or is it splicing it completely in half?
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
the
artery.
Artery should be on top, and the vein should be on top.
Artery.
Go ahead.
Sometimes
you saw it. A woman letting the kidney lie flat, shown in the figure. That's the kidney that has length.
Cherry could never be a surgeon.
You know,
I
did.
It's not quite going to work up from the outside out here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we have extra
I only get one chance to do this.
Yeah,
just
start
for
Oh, that's sharp. Yeah, those are brand new scalpels,
guys.
That's why I stressed
in
the safety.
Mm-hmm.
So
I'd be out. I'd much rather use it. Would you?
Oh,
it's going to be fine when someone like this
is
in a
look at that.
Look at that.
Don't say that.
Sorry.
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 I got to sneeze. Sneeze, half throw up.
Are we supposed to have the little pins?
Would you like pins?
If you want to pin it down.
What are we dissecting?
We're dissecting.
Kidney.
Oh,
oh my god.
Do
get
I need
the
to be
get the phone. I'm trying it up on Facebook.
We should probably leave the door open though, just so the other teachers down the hall can enjoy the smell too.
Oh yeah.
Or
what animals are these?
These should be sheep kidneys.
Humans.
Yeah, they're sheep.
Human
yeah,
no, they're sheep kidneys.
You
can handle it.
You gotta laugh at these things.
Hey, we're trying to hit up on fast.
I don't even remember what happened.
I think they're all slimming down.
Are you good?
Alright.
I'm so excited.
The ladies told me. She said, okay. I said, I don't know. Did she send somebody down with her? She goes, no, it's one of our girls.
Yeah, I was
a dog. I had to exactly what I thought when I said.
Hey, is everybody ready to point out the parts and show me the path of what in here? Actually, you know what you guys could do? You guys could put pins in the different parts. That's very smart.
It looks all the same to me.
Okay, so we're gonna do this.
Oh my gosh.
These are several parts of the kidney turned from the outside to the center of the kidney, finally to the following portion. The renal cortex is the solid looking outer part of the kidney, so it's the white stuff.
This is the
point part.
Oh,
wait. Oh, I thought it was the middle part.
Those are like the veins.
It contains many small arteries and veins that carry blood to and form approximately 1 million nephrons located.
Unless these are small, but ours, the book at least says they're about 5 inches
tall.
That's all there is.
I'm gonna be on Facebook today.
You're gonna be Facebook
so
famous.
Cool.
Facebook famous. Everyone's always gonna be like, I'm not sure what
I'm doing.
If you stay a little bit longer, you're gonna be able to throw up.
I didn't mark them.
It's not, I didn't even smell that much when it was.
Don't get caught in here when we need somebody.
The cable seeds are just going to be
part
of that.
You didn't like the heart?
I hate going over the heart.
It makes
my chest and stuff feel weird.
Oh, really?
I mean, I think it's just all mental. Really.
Yeah.
Like, that's the one organ I don't enjoy, like, looking at and learning about.
What?
I don't know.
What is it? The heart?
Because the artery is thinner. Filter
the
And then
I can't really see them, but I'd say
the
rattles.
Can we put some of these
attachment on the black one, the little part that goes out?
What?
To the middle of the
embroidery.
Like, not just the little tail.
Yeah.
Is
it in your hair?
No, my hair smells good.
Oh, wow.
But
I'm a client.
Those are
good too.
Okay. I need to wash my hands. My hair
is
dark.
I wish. Does it look this color? Because it's dead. Does stuff normally look like this color? Or is it just recently taken?
This one's like, what does the normal color of a living
would you see it like this if you cut it open?
It's
going to
be more that color because
okay.
of all the blend.
We need to do a live.
Like this.
It's not that.
Yeah.
Where the next front is.
Yeah. We'll just have to kill
starlights.
Real time assessment.
Leave him alone.
It's a kidney bean.
Oh my god. So the stuff that puts back into the blood.
So very
what is the
blood
flow?
Well, you don't have to, but she said you can if you want.
Gotcha.
What about
it's just one step.
Urine itself? That's what
I'm saying.
What part of these are going to flow through the
urine?
That's lit.
Yes.
Flows
through the middle.
Did you cut out of the
She said I could do it after I get it. Let me draw that.
Did they have to cut it in half?
Yes, we did. It was
did we have to?
No, I mean like it was closed and you cut it open. Wow.
Yes, it was.
They did make
cutting. We enjoy cutting it.
Better a kidney than a heart, apparently. I think that would be fascinating to look at. I think.
Learning about the cardiovascular system kind of makes me feel uncomfortable.
Because
of what I'm thinking right now.
It's doing these
doing
things.
All of that.
And you're like,
but you don't even have to make it do it.
Vortex.
You don't even have to make
it
do it.
Isn't
it's
that? Just involuntary.
Yeah.
But
is this a big chalice?
Does
she have two kidneys too?
We have three kidneys. We found that out the other day. Yeah, these are both.
We don't have three. She has four right now.
Six.
So it goes actually the splintering is gonna happen in the medulla / cortex. So it's in the cortex.
But I'm saying like
the stuff
that's
in
the
blood.
These are both Billy Bob. Those are
Billy
Bob.
Okay.
Those are Joe.
Can you tell if it's a male?
Female?
Not by looking at it.
Okay, so
yes.
The blood
this was a
like
male.
Bones,
male.
You can, right?
This was a male.
Deciding not to believe anything.
You don't say that.
Yeah. But it's supposed to be the waist goes into the canvas.
This makes me think of
so it comes in
that's an excellent
cauliflower
by the way
when you cut it and you see those
I honestly a little scared that she said that
I need to get they will cut somebody up
okay so
don't cut uncut yourself.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know what I'm saying though? Like someone comes up and messes with you like this ain't this like a bald box cutter.
That's probably why they use it to cut people off.
Oh, for real. I already got
surgery.
I'm just saying, like, it's so low key though.
Oh.
Like no one knows you had it. Like, so walk through your car trying to mess you up. They don't even know you had that in your hand.
You use one of these to cut your human?
Okay, so it goes to the cortex.
That's
weird.
And then it flows.
Did
y'all?
Oh, no.
She sounded so nerdy.
Yeah, she sounded so, like, nerdy professional.
Did anybody faint for that? Because I remember my brother talking about that in his class, and like the toughest guy in his class was like,
the little guy somewhere.
Y'all saw the body this year?
No, we just saw it.
It's
pretty cool.
Well, that's easier. Back in the day, the classes probably had to go.
Yes. Boom. In the box that I found when I first got here, there were main implants.
Okay.
So it's just the pelvis is like the joint.
Yeah, that's nice.
It's like if you flex the pelvis.
That's like when people pierce their own ears.
Oh.
I don't know how people do that.
I've done that before.
You've
done
me
it.
Too.
Like,
me too.
What?
Did you have? Did yours have a weird sound like?
Why are those piercing all on ears? Gonna get gauges. Red flags. Red flags.
I did hear that it's better to get your ear pierced at a tattoo parlor than it is at like Claire's.
Really?
Yeah, because they're more
it's
sterile.
I heard it's good to get a tattoo in someone's random basement. So.
Do you know Smarter Every Day? That guy. He's from Alabama.
That's me.
Sorry, I didn't mean to laugh. You're good. Anyway, he did an episode on tattoo and showed what it looks like, and he's like, I can do it on my skin, but it was without ink, so it just showed, and he does a slow motion picture of it, and I didn't realize that, well, yeah, that, but I didn't realize, you know how you see people with, like, sleeves, and it looks like it's, like, airbrushed. It's, like, 10 needles, like, to give it that look, and it's like, oh my goodness. Yeah. And
so,
then it takes a long time for your liver to filter out that ink. That's why it gets faded. That's what I was learning. Like, they fade over time because your liver is doing what it's supposed to be doing. Filter out the toxins.
Yes.
So you said it comes.
So you're putting your liver in extra work.
What tattoo are we going to get when I graduate?
I'll draw it.
Let's get one. No, what tattoo are you going to get when we graduate?
I'll draw it.
When I graduate, me and you are going to get like tabernacle torches on our back.
And it's got those big letters.
With flames going in.
Airbrushed look.
Yeah. 100%. As soon as I graduate.
I'm actually getting a tattoo after
that. Will you draw it?
I'm not going to draw it.
Why not?
Because my mama said no. Here, you're going to get this one. My mom.
Your mom is going to tell you what to tattoo.
I did draw it. I drew it out and she was like, oh, well, this one I found on Pinterest is cuter. But you can add your own little touch to it. And I'm like,
see, if I was going to get one, I would draw it myself. Because I don't want to look through and be like, yeah, I'll get this one. That somebody else probably has. Like, it's supposed to be.
How do you trace the flow?
Don't
touch my stuff. What do you mean by how we trace it?
But this is not a disc.